Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be doing a Project Pan update. I started back in January, pulled out 17 items that I wanted to use up for this year and have an update for you because I have used up some items and there's still some items that I'm working on. But anyway, it is what it is. I think I've done pretty good so far on what I've used and the progress I've been making, so doing good. And this will probably be the last update until the end of the year because I don't foresee me using any of the products that I have left up, unfortunately. But anyway, let's get started. Working on my meteorites pearl finishing powder from Guerlain. I did add to these, so in my defense I added, but I definitely still have probably another year's worth of using these. I'm telling you, they last forever. If you're ever in doubt on purchasing these because of the price, don't, because they just last forever. I use these as my last step to my makeup. I just put them all over the face and then I take a little brush and kind of buff them in, and it's just so pretty and I love them and I cannot wait for the holiday ones to come out this year for 2017. They look really pretty. Another product that I'm still working on, I've made a little bit of progress with it, is the More Pacific Enzyme Peel. I am probably down to about here. This is where I started at when I started my Project Pan. I use this about 3 times a week. I use it in the morning time to cleanse my face. It's a very gentle but effective peel. I like to use this with my micellar water. And the reason why this lasts for so long is that when you pour it out, it dispenses the amount that you need to use each time. So you're not using too much, you're not using too less. You're using the exact amount that it wants you to use when you pour it out. So it is a pricey item, but cost effective, cost wise, it's very cost effective because it lasts for so long. So I do like it and I would definitely repurchase it if I get done with it. I have a feeling that this is probably going to last me well into next year, probably at least half of the year. Another product that I'm still working on is the Philosophy, the micro delivery peel that I started to work on. I've used it a few times, made a little bit of progress, not a whole lot. I use this probably maybe twice a month and it just takes a little bit, and it is a physical exfoliant, not a physical, a manual exfoliant, because you have to run it around your face. It has these little bitty particles that exfoliate the skin. I just don't use it too often because I just feel like for my aging skin, it's just a little bit too harsh. So that's why I only use it just a couple times a month, because I just don't want to cause any damage to my skin. I'm trying to get that to focus. I'm having problems with my camera today, not wanting to focus. It's not working right. And it's making me mad. But anyway, it is what it is. Okay, so those, I started to say those are the only things I'm still working on. I'm still working on this little guy from MAC. This is the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. It's not that it's a bad product. It's not brightening enough for my eyelids. So it is, just an eyeshadow base that you would use. I like Painterly better, but still working on that, but anyway, still have a little ways to go. I know I won't finish that before the end of the year. Okay, so now on to the products that I have actually finished that were in my Project Pan. And first we'll start with this guy here. This was from Becca. This was the the backlit primer filter, primer guy, whatever, that has a little pump that pumps it out. I wasn't that big of a fan of this. I didn't feel like it was that good of a primer. It did make your skin glowy, so I guess if that was something you're really wanting a product to do, then maybe for that aspect you would like it. But as far as a primer, which is what I bought it for, I didn't feel like it was that great. So I would not and won't be repurchasing that. Another product I finished was from the Giorgio Armani, and I'm not for sure exactly what this is called, but it's the little peach corrector. I know everybody talks about it right here. This little guy lasted a really, really long time. I even took the stopper out so I could really make sure that I got everything out of here. It has just a little brush tip applicator. You may not even be able to see that, probably not. Anyway, I just used it underneath the eyes with my concealer to help with correcting. As far as a peach corrector goes, out of the ones that I've tried, for my skin tone, this color tone was really, really good, because I have one here from Lancome that is just way too orange and too dark. But this was a really good color tone, not too orange, not too pink. It was just right. So when I first started using this, I wasn't that big of a fan of it. Didn't really think it was just all that. But the more I used it, the more I like it. And now that I don't have it and haven't been using it, I can kind of tell the difference. And I will probably be getting another one of these at a later date. I have some other products that I want to use up first before I repurchase that. Anyway, I have a product from MAC. This is the MAC Prep and Prime. And the color, I don't know. I can't tell it. I don't remember, but it was one of these little guys that has a little brush tip on it, and you click it up to get the product out. It kind of was the same lines as this as far as a corrector, but it was more on the pink or the rose color, and it was okay. I'm not going to repurchase it. It was in my collection. I had it for a while. I wanted to use it up and threw it in that project pan, so I'd make sure I used it, and I did. I had also added this into the project pan. It was just a little deluxe size sample of the MAC Strobe Cream, the Luminizer. It was all right. It's not anything that I was just totally wowed by. That's why I put it into my collection, just to make sure I used it up. It's okay. Okay, now this I really did like. I think as far as a drugstore eyeshadow line, the Milani, the Bella line, is really good. This is the second one of these from this line that I've had in a project pan that I've used. And this is the Belle Ivory eyeshadow that I have put in my project pan, and I used it all up. I used it all over the eyelid as an eyelid base to put other eyeshadows on top. So was good and enjoyed using it, but it's all gone. I did finish up a eyebrow powder. This side right here was what was in my project pan, not the the wax portion of it. This is from Benefit. It was in light. It's the Brow Zing. I had had it for a while. The lid had even broken off, so I wanted to use that up, and I am glad to tell you that it is all gone. That powder, I use it all up and is gone. Another brow product that I had in my project pan was this one from It Cosmetics. This is the Build-A-Brow in the color Universal Taupe. When I started using it, it was all dried up, so I stirred it all up to try and get to where I could use it, and I did a really, really good job of using it up. There's still product that's around the edge. I don't know if you can see that. That's around the edge. But it is so dried and caked up. I tried to scrape some of it off and stir it and try and get it back to creamy. But it's gone. So that is gone. Done with that. And the last thing that I have that was in my project pan that I finished was this guy here. And this was from MAC. This was from last summer? The summer collection. Anyway, it was Aphrodite Shell Bronzer. And I did use it completely up. Toward the end, it was getting to where it was hard to use. So I took it out and put it into a little container and smashed it and made it into a powder to where I could use it, and I used all that, so it's all completely gone. And now that it's gone, I'm kind of sad it's gone because I really did enjoy the color tone of that. And with it being that special edition, I don't think you can get that color tone again, but anyway, so that is gone. So that'd be a back to MAC item, and this would be a back to MAC. I don't know if they do these little bitty samples, but I'll throw it in there anyway and just to see what they say. Anyway, so that is it for my project pan update. Like I said, I will do one at the end of the year and just do a total wrap up of the products that I used and the dollar amount of what that equaled to. But like I said, those other products that I showed you that I'm still working on, I don't foresee me finishing those at all. So anyway, so there won't be anything to really update between now and the end of December. So anyway, so thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you enjoyed. I do post videos on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursdays. I do beauty, lifestyle, and what else do I do? A little bit of luxury thrown in here and there. And if you would be so inclined, push that subscribe button. Also, push the bell icon so that you're notified of all the future videos that I do. Thank you so much, and I will talk to you soon.